Question 5 may not have the high profile of some of the other ballot questions, but it's no less controversial. It has much to do with political turf. It has Republicans fighting Democrats and even Democrats fighting each other.
It's the congressional redistricting question that, if Marylanders vote no on, would cause the congressional district lines to be redrawn from the governor's proposed plan. Republicans organized the petition drive to put the issue on the ballot, but one of the loudest voices against the plan belongs to state comptroller Peter Franchot.
And it's done in a smoke-filled back room in Annapolis by a couple of people who have big crayons, and they draw these districts not in the public interest, but in the interest of the elected officials.
Another Democrat, Montgomery County Councilmember Phil Andrews, says the map is gerrymandering. Andrews says the newly drawn 3rd congressional district, which includes parts of 4 counties and Baltimore City, is the 3rd least compact in the country.
There's no way an independent commission would come up with a district like that. This looks like blood spatter, from a crime scene rather than a congressional district.
The redistricting plan, which was introduced by the governor and passed by this year's General Assembly, is based on census data. It remains in effect for 10 years. The governor continues to support the plan, which he says allows more than 70% of Marylanders to stay in their current congressional district. His office also says the plan meets the goals of the Legislative Black Caucus and keeps intact the growing African-American population in Prince George's and Charles counties. One Prince George's lawmaker who continues to support the plan is Prince George's County Delegate Jolene Ivey.
I know it looks weird, there's no doubt about it, but the people who will get to elect their next congressperson will be electing someone who's going to represent them and do a good job.
But Common Cause Maryland, an independent nonpartisan organization, is also weighing in. Telling CNS-TV, the map is a perfect example of elected officials creating districts to suit their own needs and not the needs of the people of Maryland.
We want districts that are compact, where people not only know who their member of Congress or their member of the legislature is, but they also know who else is in the district.
On November 6th, it will be up to the voters to decide. I'm Kelsey Pospisil reporting for CNS-TV.